wasn't in the cell all night and no one's seen her in the showers.
Yeah, something's up.
Stop looking at me. I don't know.
You have got to do something, Rita. Yeah.
Where's Nancy?
Oh, don't tell me you've lost her.
Where have they taken her?
Get back to your seat.
Oh. Hey!
Where the hell have you been?
At a police station.
And?
I'm being released.
How come?
I just told them the truth.
That you didn't do it?
And they believed you?
Oh, you bloody ripper, Nance.
Yeah, well, when are you going?
Today. I just came to say goodbye. I will miss you all.
Please, but half as much as we'll miss you.
Yeah, I mean, I thought I was the only one getting out, eh?
Now, you will visit me, I hope, with that baby.
Yeah, Nance.
Sure. Oh, you haven't heard the news yet. He's got a name now. Julian Larry.
Oh, that's lovely. I'm so pleased.
And the Waipai Larry's named after you.
I'm very happy about that, Lexi. Well, goodbye, everybody. Take care. Bye-bye. Look after yourself, won't you?
You ready, McCormick?
Yes.
All right, you lot aren't going anywhere. Get on with your breakfast. Connors!
All I want is a good night's sleep and a comfortable bed.
It's been a long night.
Nancy!
Are you all right?
Yes, of course.
Did Peter take it all right?
No, but we'll get that sorted out in time.
Sure you will. Well, good luck. You can ride with me anytime.
You will keep out of trouble.
I never started, you know that.
Oh, has a habit of following you around.
It's a family curse.
Now, I want you to promise me one thing. You'll ignore Joan's baiting. You won't fight. And you won't take on Kath.
That's one promise. You don't want much, do you?
I don't want you stopping in here forever.
Oh, no. I wish I had your braking power sometimes. You taught me a thing or two about cooling it. The van's waiting.
All right.
You better. Or send me bikey mates round to you.
Make sure you bring a spare helmet.
This should keep Connors off my back for a while anyway.
With that ox, Jenkins and the fairy princess backing her up, hardly.
We'll manage all right. Here, it's time to start moving some merchandise. That's pretty. An admirer?
Yeah, but she doesn't know it yet.
You really are as low as they come, aren't you?
It's junk. I'm just looking after it till she wakes up, it's gone. Bound to be a finder's fee. Hope you've got a safe spot for that.
Don't you worry, I have.
A rainy day?
None of your business.
Wouldn't be hard to make it my business.
Don't push your luck.
Don't worry, I'm a real wimp. Just like your Mr. Adams. Come to think of it, we might have a lot more in common. Think I might go and have a chat with him.
There's only you and me now.
So?
Well, nothing. But it won't be easy.
You want Maxwell and Spider walking all over us?
Course not. But I don't want me head torn off for pulling something without backup either.
We don't need it. We've got Auntie Ida and Maxwell right where we want her.
Yeah.
And where's that?
What's your plan?
Nothing.
Oh, come on. You're going to get Kath, aren't you?
That doesn't concern you now.
It does. You're my mates, and if there's something I can do, I want to help.
You can by clearing out of here and taking care of our kid.
Look, Reed, I know you didn't do nothing when I was pregnant because you didn't want us getting hurt, but now
that's nothing. Listen, once you get out of here, you're going straight. I'm not having the cops knocking on your door because of something that happens in here.
You are going to get Kath, then, eh?
Lexi, out! And no snooping!
Jeez, Reed, you're a bit hard on her.
I meant it. I don't want her involved. If this thing works out, We got Maxwell down the tube, and we can forget we ever laid eyes on him.
Oh, there you are, Patterson. Come on, get your stuff together. You're going to the hospital now.
Now?
Yep, here.
What's this?
It's a dress Wyndham sent it in.
Oh, beauty, huh? Look, I'll just nip back and say goodbye.
No, you won't. Now get in here and get your gear together.
But it'll only take a tick, and the stuff's already packed.
Look, you've already had your party, and you had plenty of time to say goodbye this morning. Now get to it.
It's no skin off your nose to let me say I'm going now. You're going to think I'm really rude.
You won't be seeing them again. Now, Patterson, you've got a child to care for. Responsibilities. I'd think about that if I were you. Because if you keep on the straight and narrow, maybe, just maybe, your kid won't end up in a place like this.
They looked after me. I mean, if it wasn't for Alice, me and the kid would be up the creek.
You can write and thank them. You can write, can't you?
Mrs. Morris, can I say goodbye to my mates? It won't take long.
Mr. Morris, the driver's waiting. He hasn't got all day.
Yes, Miss Ferguson. Come along, Patterson. Sign out over here.
It's not the same, Mrs. M. You know, I didn't get a chance to say half the stuff I wanted.
Rise.